Hello everybody, back together with another exciting tutorial. This tutorial we learn and actually do a very very good project into After Effects and 3ds Max software. Maybe you think about mix and composite the 3D object into a real footage. It can be a video, it can be a picture or whatever that makes per frame. It's to learn to and actually know how to composite and mix a 3D object into a real footage and real peak. For example, just look at this. It's a very very simple composite. As you can see, it's a car. It's a super sport car. And it's a final result. But before this, I had this picture. As you can see, I took this picture around myself in school, in street. You can take a simple picture that you want to use into your graphic artistic render. And after that, I composited this 3D object into this picture with this shadow, and it's almost real. It's so cool and special for me, and so cool. Just pay attention. The first step to do this project is have your 3D model into a 3ds Max, Blender, or whatever. The next is have a simple video that you can take it in the street, in school, in whatever, in any, every location that you can take a simple video. Then import that video into your timeline. As you can see, it's my video that I imported into Adobe After Effects CC 2015. As you can see, it's a simple video. You must export it, go on file and then on export and add to render. On here, I lost less output module settings, just convert the formats from AVI to JPG sequence, then press OK, then choose location, and then press render. After that, you can see you have few separate pictures per frame. Every frame can be a picture. For example, as you can see here, we have 218 frame into this video that you can see we explored this simple. As you can see, it's getting the video. Okay, so it can be your guide to composite and mix your 3D model. So get the main trick, then use track camera and right click and then press track camera and wait for this system. It can get lazy in the background. Tracking actually trace your 3D trace your video that it's a special point and actually system in our trick, because tracking is so important and it's a special part into our trick. As you can see, it's going to be okay. It's going to be loaded and good. Just it can take a few minutes or few seconds. It depends on your videos times and videos resolution. We'll wait. Nice. Stop. Yeah, as you can see, we have so many nodes, and these are so many points. And over, you can see the between these points among these points, you can see a circular pattern and picture that you can use it to tracking. For example, you can get a simple point, for example this system, and create four nodes and camera. You guys, you can see here we have four nodes, and these are each other. Get a separate pivot together, and these are so special. It's kind of no problem. The main point is here, just choose all of these nodes, track nodes, and 3D camera. Go on file, and on a scripts, you can see here we have a simple script and a 3D export. It's a special script that I installed into After Effects, and it's not default for After Effects. As you can see, if you wanna install it, you must download and import it and into a scripts folder into your After Effects installation directory. Export to 3ds Max, and here is so special, shift the composite center to 000. After that, scale on 1:1, then close it and set a name for your file. For example, they export, wait for this system, it can be very helpful for you. Okay, so now you can see we have a script here, and it gets every time, every frame, get your position and axis. After open 3ds Max server, and on a simplify a new file, you must get scripting ground script and imported script. As you can see here, we have four nodes and four patterns for dummies. Choose all of your camera and nodes that get group, it's so special. Get cam or whatever, then rotate it with the help of angle stamped view 90 degree. Okay, now get the first of that to 0 point, for example here. Okay, it's 0 point, we'll get up central. Okay, now import the video and configuration. You can go on custom plus configuration viewports and get on background, use files, animate background, match bitmap, and hold before start. Files and get here videos and your folder, for example, it can be here. Get a sequence. If you choose first frame, that okay, that get number, okay, that press active to view. Okay, so it's done. As you can see, we don't have a very cool system because, you know, it's not special. Our grid is not fit with our video, that you must fix it. Rotate it. Okay, it's cool. And get center. Okay, it's cool, cool, so good. Okay, as you can see here, it gets forward, and you can see down, but it's not special. I didn't track it good, and because our track is not special cool, because you can, you know, it's getting together and these are moving, and it's not good. I track it, I did it for also just get a very good view for myself, view in the video. And it's our guide, all of these dummies and nulls, these are my guide to position and locate my 3D object. So now just pay attention, just go on light and V-ray, V-ray light, and get dummy, dumb light, and here I'll use 3D map, a 2D map, get out, and here you can see you must use a simple picture, it can be your 3D. For example, here I have this picture for light. You can see here it's a picture. Okay, now get a render, take a render. As you can see, this is a render, but it's not good for us. It's not good because we don't have any picture, any background into our scene. And just pay attention, and the other special point is choose your dummy light and invisible it, enable invisible, and then take a render. As you can see here, it's black and we don't have any cool background. Get 8, press 8, and you can see here you can use map, go on bitmap and choose it and use sequence. Okay, now press open. Okay, and press M to open material editor. As you can see here, also you can use it on here and drag it up into every slot that you like. And on mapping, use a screen. Now press OK. Now take a render. As you can see, we have a very cool background from our render, and it's done. And every frame that you get forward, it's done, and it's real time. As you can see, this is our render, and so cool, and it doesn't have any problem. So now get a simple system. Just create a simple plan to receive shadows. And open material editor, and here apply a simple material, and then change the main system of our material from vary material to, on general tab, to use matte shadow. It's special, doesn't have any system. As you can see here, it just gets the shadows. Let's import our 3D object. For example, it can be a car, it can be a home, house, whatever you like. I would rather import a car remodel. For example, this Mercedes-Benz LS is high poly, and you can use it, so cool. Okay, I make it group, name of that car. Scale it, line it, use line to plane, minimum and maximum and z-axis. Okay, now down, as you can see, you can see the render. But on render, wait, okay, it's done. This is our render. It increase our resolution because it's so high. Again, I convert it better. As you can see, this is a renderer. It doesn't have any good shadow into our system. It's so fade, and it's not special for us because we want to make it okay, like this render. As you can see here, I take a render and we have a very good shadow here. Now how we can get it? First of all, we'll scale it. Okay, a little more. Okay, now you can take a sunlight from here, our degrees, and never get yes, just press no, because we have our background. Okay, now on modify tab, intensity multiplier. Multiplier, get on 1 on 1 per 100, and increase the size multiplier to 40 or whatever. Now we can get a very, very good sunlight and shadows. But the other side, get our render settings, irradiance map, and use ambient occlusion, the 3 or 2 number can be variable. You must choose that to on the best point. Get current preset to very low. You can use it medium or high on final renders. Get it to 50. You can now take a render. It's done. Okay, now as you can see, we have a very cool shadow. it's a very good render. And after that, you can import it on Photoshop and any other software to post production and have a very cool result. But after this system, you can see you have a very very cool position in this render. For example, I start it. Get forward. In the other view, you can get a 3D render also on this view. It's so cool. Well, in HDRI system, you can't do this because you didn't track your 3D object. But on this system, you can use it so simple and it's so helpful. It's for final result. It can be final result, or you can put it on Photoshop or Coral to post-production and have a simple edit on this software, on this render. It's very cool. Hope you enjoyed and like it. And this is a very final result. As you can see here, this is our 3D render. But here is final result with some edits, a lot of blur. You can get like this photo. And also you can get it better. For example, you can take a few frames render that then you can import it to and to After Effects and then get a multi frames render. You can import it into a video and get a very cool mix and composite together. Okay, so as you can see, it's so cool, and you can see gets shadow, and it's very cool for you. Also have a very good reflection that can like it can be like this ground, and it's so cool. Hope you like and enjoy it. Please subscribe our channel on YouTube or on our website, and goodbye.